Welcome to Staveley Salvation Army. It's St. George's Day, and in some calendars it says that it's Shakespeare's Day. So the 23rd of April 2023, on this beautiful morning, we're going to sing Jesus, what a beautiful name. Son of God, Son of Man, Lamb that was slain. Joy and peace, strength and hope, grace that blows all fear away. Jesus, what a beautiful name. Let's enjoy singing together this song. Reading is taken from the Message translation, and I'm reading from Philippians chapter 2, where it says rejoicing together. What I'm getting getting at, friends, says Paul, is that you should simply keep on doing what you've done from the beginning. Does that ring true today? When I was living among you, you lived in responsive obedience. Now that I'm separated from you, keep it up. Better yet, redouble your efforts. Be energetic in your life of salvation, reverent and sensitive before God. That energy is God's energy, deep, deep within you. God himself willing and working at what will give him the most pleasure. Do everything readily and cheerfully. No bickering, no second guessing. Go out into the world uncorrupted. A breath of fresh air. Provide people with a glimpse of good living and of the living God. Carry the light that you have been given. You'll be living proof that I didn't do all this for nothing. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, as we come to this Salvation Army Hall, is your church, your home. We come with hearts full of thanksgiving. We thank you for St. George and how we can remember him. And we thank you for Shakespeare and all those words that you gave him to put in sonnets and plays. So today, we thank you for this opportunity of sharing together. Bless us now. Amen. In the Salvation Army, we're privileged to be able, in some corps, to have a brass band. And it's my privilege to play in a very small group, but the message is given out from the heart. And so now the opportunity is for us to listen to a band, whether it's the International Staff Band or other bands that have been recorded, but really appreciate that people play from the heart as salvationists, Christians first, but they have this opportunity of giving out God's message through their playing. song is There Is a Redeemer. We've had Easter. We know what God did for us. He sent his son to die for us, for our sins. And we sing this song, There Is a Redeemer. And the Bible reading attached to this is from Psalm, a verse from Psalm and a verse from Isaiah. Isaiah 47 and verse 4. So speaks our Redeemer, who will save Israel from Babylon. Sit in the darkness and be silent. I'll start. So speaks the Redeemer. I will take no vengeance upon you, but repent. The Lord Almighty is his name. Sit in the darkness and appreciate the silence. There is a Redeemer for you and for me. Now, we have a choir in the Salvation Army, and they're called songsters. Some corps have a mixed group, some corps have just female voices. But we have the opportunity to share in the songsters today. He's ours just now.
Thank you.
Our prayer for today. Worthy, take the scroll, open its seals. Come, speak to us through your word, whether it be song or verse or sermon. Speak to us through those words. Then make the kingdom come. To the one on the throne, to the Lamb, blessings, honour and glory for age after age. Give us ears to hear. Our next song is song 239 in our songbook, which is a helpful one for today. All the world is waiting, waiting, Lord, for thee. How creation groans in anguish, crying to be free. Lord, we trust thy promises to quickly come again. Even so, Lord Jesus, come. Oh, come. All the world is longing, longing to be free from the power of sin and death and darkness. Let it be. Holy Spirit, move the hearts of those in unbelief. Even so, Lord Jesus, come. Oh, come. All the world is hoping love and peace to see. Sons of God are hoping, waiting, trusting in thee. Glorious, that future day when raised to die no more. Even so, Lord Jesus, come. All the world is waiting. Are you waiting? Your invitation is here today to come and meet with Jesus, to come and feel the promise that he gives, to know the love, to be focused on God's goal for your life. Do you do everything readily and cheerfully? God is speaking to each one of us. And our message for St. George's Day, think of who St. George was as British English people. For he was our saint. And then Shakespeare. Many of you would have studied Shakespeare at school. The Merchant of Venice, Macbeth, the sonnets. Oh, some of the sonnets are so beautifully written. And this week, while I've been sorting things in my house, I found my complete works of Shakespeare and was able to read some of it to my husband, who said, "Oh, no. When looking at Henry the Fourth, Part One, oh spite, oh hell, I see you are all bent and set against me for your merriment." And then it went. I don't think so, dear. Not today. But I was only reading Shakespeare. And how the Lord spoke to me when checking today, the 23rd of April, Shakespeare Day. So that's lovely, isn't it? I can remember when doing exams and all that sort of thing. But what's the message? The message is that we are given gifts. Some of us can write properly. Some of us can sing beautifully. Some of us can play our instruments well and do solos and, well, we all have gifts, and on today we can read Shakespeare, or some of us can. Shakespeare's easier than Chaucer. I struggle with a little bit of Chaucer, but I'm told that to read Chaucer, you just put an E on most of the words, and you know, it's there. But Shakespeare's a lot better. And so I encourage you to read your Bible, because some of the old authorised version seems to be like Shakespeare. And then ask God to give you that word, as he's given me this word today. Do everything readily and cheerfully. And that's what I'm being trying to do and encourage you to do. So we're going to sing "How Lovely on the Mountains Are the Feet of Him Who Brings Good News," because we need good news in our society today. Jesus is alive. He is risen. That's the good news. On St. George's Day, on Shakespeare Day. Don't just leave it for Easter. Tell everyone. So let's sing "How Lovely on the Mountains Are the Feet of Him Who Brings Good News."
Thank you.
meeting to a close. I just want to read to you our next song, which is 355 in our songbook. Beautiful Lord, wonderful Saviour, I know for sure all of my days are held in your hand. Crafted into your perfect plan, you gently call me into your presence, guiding me by your Holy Spirit. Teach me, dear Lord, to live all of my life through your eyes. Take me, mold me, use me, fill me. I give my life to the potter's hand. Call me, guide me, lead me, walk beside me. I give my life to the potter's hand.
Captured by Lord, we are so thankful that you are the potter. And we're so thankful that you have us in your hand, Lord. And that even though none of us know right now what the future holds, God, we know that you know, because you are the potter, you are the master. And we know that you have us in your hand, Lord. Amen.
May we do just that today, as we are able to move on this week and think about what we're doing and why we're doing it. Jesus, what a beautiful name. There is a Redeemer. And friends, all the world is waiting. Waiting. So it's up to us to go out and tell other people of Jesus. Bless you and help you today. Amen.
World reveals and wars to us. knowing.